Yes, in this we are going to see the iterator functions which will be applicable for the loop, various loops in PHP. So every PHP array keeps track of the current element you are working with. So the pointer to the current element is known as the iterator. When you pass it in, when the array element is passed in the for or while loop, then it will keep track with an iterator. The current element is said to be the iterator. So these are all some of the iterator functions. Current. This function returns the element currently pointed by the iterator. Reset. So when you are in the middle of the loop, reset will force the, again, the iterator to access the first element. Then next, it will point to the next element. Maybe the previous, you can move to the previous element. Then n, like how reset moves to the first element, n moves to the last element. Each and every element is accessed next in the order of the declaration. Then key, it returns the key of the current element. That is, in an associative key and value, it returns the key value. Now see an example here. Already we are using this each. What we have seen here, each function, that is, it points to the next element. So this type program already we have seen. Anyway, reset will move to the starting element of the array, and then we are using a while, then we are using a list function where we are using two values, key and value. So when you iterate the array with while loop, the each function will point to the first element, second element, and third element. It automatically, it will move to the next element without moving a pointer. So initially it will be pointing to the first element, then in the loop it points to the next element, and so on. Now we are printing the value, okay. So here key and value pair, that will be assigned to that. Now when you see the output, this address is nothing but what we have given this example. See here. Already we have declared that address, array, these two values we have sent. So numerical array. So by using this, we are printing it like this. So the each key, dollar key here, it will take the index as the key. So zero is the value. Likewise, the second index, that is zero, the first index, it is, it will be printed. Now, the next example we are going to say is, you can extract data from array and make them as an individual variable. We know array is used for representing of representing with a single name many values. So let us say consider this array, associative array. Here we have declared the actor as an associative array, and for that we have assigned the values. So this is the key and this is the value, key value pair. Now what this extract will do, to execute the extract function. Once you have extracted, this will be considered as a variable. So this dollar Rajini, yeah, this will be considered as a variable and the value assigned. So this array you are converting into individual variables. So how you are converting, the key value you are taking it as the array. So this will become the the key value becomes the variable. So if you see this echo statement, here we are printing this as if it is a variable. So when I say dollar Rajini, once you have applied this extract to the array actor, so this becomes, Rajini becomes a variable, Surya becomes a variable, this becomes a variable. For this, the value is this. So now we'll see how the program executes. Here, when I execute this program, the value is present here. Sure, that will be printed as such. So extract is used to extract values from the array, from the key value pair. The value will be extracted, and the key becomes the individual variable. The reverse of array, so that will be done. So you can After that, you will work out on those variables as if they are single declared variables. The next one is, already we have seen the in the while loop we are using the list function. Now we'll see how to we'll see more on that. Here, say we are declaring an array, a numerical array, because we are not declaring the key value pair. If you don't declare and if you use it like an associative array, the index becomes the key. So these are all the some five elements are there in this array called $x. Now we are using a function, list function, and we are declaring the variables, some two variables, and we are assigning to them the array. So after this, what happens? This since we have declared only two variables, the first value dog is assigned to this and cat is assigned to this. So you will be able to extract the values from the array and assign it to variables. Now this will be treated as, of course, x is there. Dollar x is consist of all the values. But now you will extract the values from the array and you can treat them as an individual variable. So when you print this, it will print $1 will print dog, $2 will print cat. So since you have used only two variables, only the first two values will be printed. Now if I want from the middle, I want only this value or this, this and this. So how to do that? Yes, we can do. So here $1, I have used one variable. Then after that, just another comma here. See, after the variable, comma is there. Again, I have given comma, which means you skip this value. Then we use the variable name 3, then 4. Now, when you print this, what it will do is it will skip the value cat. And then for this, 1, dog will be assigned. For this 3, horse will be assigned. Then for this 4, elephant will be assigned. So if I want only the elephant, I can give that also. So now I give some use a list operator. Let me say yearly. But in order to do that, I have to skip 1, 2, 3. Okay, the three elements. So when I give three operate three commas, this is skip, this is skip, this is skip. I want only for this, and then process, which is equal to $x. So after executing this, you will be having elephant stored in this variable ele. I'll see how it executes. See here, the first list operator will take from this array the first two values. So dog is assigned to 1 and cat is assigned to 3, like this. Then the next list, what we have done, 1, then you skip the second element, and then 3 and 4. So for 3, horse is assigned, for 4, elephant is assigned. Then here I have skipped 3 elements, 1, 2, 3, 3 elements, and for this, I have asked it, I just give a fourth variable. So the fourth value is assigned to the fourth variable, this variable. Now we are printing it consists of elephant. So this is how you can work with the list function as well as the extract function.